And welcome back live TLW action. And if you missed it right before the break, AK, the big headbutt right there, he takes the 1-2-3 over Ruckus to become the second number one contender, who will go up against Lil Nasty at Tidal Wars next week in whatever type of match Nasty decides to have. And that decision will be tonight. He's already made his decision and will make that announcement tonight. And you will see them both sign the contracts that they cannot touch each other until their actual match. And right now, we got a rookie match coming for you, the debut of the rookies. You know how we start the show. And right now, coming to the ring is the man, the no other than Ricky Something. Now, let me tell you something about Ricky Something. Nobody knew his name. Nobody knew this kid's name when he was in the development. The indie circuit. He was in the indie circuit for about 6 months. His kid was just flying around the room. And then when he was actually in the consideration for TLW action, everybody was like, who's this guy? His name is Something. So now, he calls himself Ricky Something. He let people know that. That's what he used to be. He made it, and some of those guys are still back there. Ricky Something, everybody. Ricky Something. And now, this guy came out of the blue. But you will see him more than once. It seems like more than twice. This is Deja Vu. Deja Vu. He has that name because of the fact of his quickness and his ability to move around the ring. And it seems like you're seeing double. He hit you once, move around, hit you again, and it's like, did he just do the same thing twice? I think he did. And that's just Deja Vu. That's just how he rolls. You know what I'm saying? But we are about to get this match started right now. Both wrestlers are ready to go. Ready to give you some action. Bell sounds. Let's go. Ricky come out firing on the offensive. He puts him in an arm bar right off the jump. But it was a rope break. Too close to the ropes. You got to try that in the middle of the ring, Ricky. You got to try that in the middle of the ring. But two exceptional young talents. These are my cruiserweights. Two more to battle for that cruiserweight title next week at Tidal Wars. And Ricky on the offensive until Deja Vu rolls out. But Ricky again. No, excuse me. Deja Vu counters. And just, whoa, does a moonsault right off of Ricky. Off his chest. Forearms to the back. And these guys are just going back and forth. These guys just too quick. I mean, you just see nothing but just flying around the ring. And Ricky Something with three kicks. Hits him right in the back of the head on the last one. And you see on the back of Ricky Something that says, all eyes on me. Oh, wait a second. Hold on. Deja Vu has been a full Nelson. And Ricky gets out of that. But on the back of Ricky Something, he has the tattoo, all eyes on me. And he didn't get that until he signed the contract to TLW Action, because now that, you know, his name Ricky Something, I told you how he got his name, and now that he's doing his thing, it's like, you guys didn't see me, now all your eyes are on me. And he's proving everybody wrong. He even wears a NBD on his gloves. It says never back down. That's his whole thing, never back down. And Deja Vu is on the offense right now. Oh my gosh, spinning body press. Right off the apron, off the top rope, I should say. Middle rope, I don't even know what to call it. but right now they're going back and forth. Deja Vu's trying some kind of kick. And look at these guys just keep countering each other until Ricky just face plants him. Oh, and then kicks him right in the chest right as he stands up. And Ricky puts him in a Boston Crab, but it's, again, too close to the ropes. Kicks out. Now these guys, Look at this. They don't stop. Like, the matches, I mean, they're just non-stop. They're machines almost. Wait a second. Deja vu. Oh, picks up Ricky after Ricky had a camel clutch. Oh, back and forth. Them right hands by Deja Vu. He'll come at you with those. Oh, and a drop kick to the face by Deja Vu as he had him in the corner. Ricky with a counter, elbow, and then chops. Just back and forth with these two. It's non-stop, but Ricky getting a little bit more offense. Throws Deja Vu in the corner. Deja Vu with a counter. They're just going back and forth still with the counters. And again, Ricky with the chop kick motion. And now he puts him in the full Nelson. He has Deja Vu in the full Nelson. And Deja Vu with the kick out. Okay. Oh, both of them. And these guys, besides Paranormal, are the two smallest guys on TLW Action. Ricky something being 5'3". Paranormal being 5'3", and this guy Deja Vu is 5'5". I mean, these guys are the smallest, but these guys probably have the biggest fight in them. And Ricky bouncing off the ropes here. Oh, and a body splash. Here we go. Oh, a pin attempt. What? Oh, I don't even think it was a one count. But it was a quick move by Ricky something. And these guys are right back to their feet again. Oh, and those right hands by Deja Vu. Now, arm drag. Deja Vu is coming out of nowhere, but Ricky just gets back up to his feet. Does right, that right hand again. And another arm drag. Deja Vu is ready. Oh, and a spinning elbow by Ricky something brings Deja Vu to the ground. And these guys are still going back and forth. Man, this is what you call action, and that's what this show is bringing you. Nothing but action. Oh, my gosh, and a drop saw by Deja Vu. Catching Ricky off guard. And here comes Deja Vu. Oh, and a flashback. Just now Deja Vu is getting a little offense. Ricky back up to his feet. Now Ricky's chopping. Ricky's punching. Ricky's chopping again. Nothing but excitement here. Here we guys go on an enziguri out of the blue. Goodness, Ricky something is on a roll here. Oh, except for that kick right there. I may have spoke too soon. And these guys are just battling. I mean, I think these guys can go up against any one of the cruiserweights right now. Especially Flash. And if you don't know about Flash. Ooh, wait a second. Hold on. This is a face planted. Deja Vu, Ricky something, put now in a submission hold. And Deja Vu rolls out of that. But if one thing about Flash is you have to know about it. Whoa, wait a second. Deja Vu with a random, just out of the blue, just kicks him. And now he has him in the camel clutch. I can't even talk about what I'm trying to talk about. Deja Vu gets picked up and dropped on his back. But again, one of the competitors that they will be facing is Flash. Flash has not lost that one-on-one match. Yeah, he only had one match officially on the show, but he has not lost a match in any dark match, no one-on-one match against any cruiserweight. So we will see how he fares at Night of Champions. And Ricky something has Deja Vu in the corner. Comes Deja. Oh, and he just kicks him right in the gut. He again, puts him in a Boston Crab. Ricky something going for all kinds of submission moves. Oh, Deja Vu with some elbows to the face. Now he jumps on him with the throwback, the face plant. Oh, Ricky something. Oh, and another enziguri. And Deja Vu is down. Uh-oh, Ricky. Ricky has him up. We might be trying something here. Chop. Kick. A reversal, a counter. Deja Vu putting him up on the turnbuckle here. What's he doing here? Oh, and a massive German suplex. Oh, spinning splash by Deja Vu. And he goes for the cover. One, two, three. And it's all over. Deja Vu with the victory. Deja Vu with the debut, with his debut match, along with Ricky Something's debut match, with the victory. These two showed these two can battle, but Deja Vu pulls one out after that big German suplex. And you just, you know, you have to let him celebrate after this. This guy earned it. If Ricky would have won, he would have earned it. That was one match that you just, that they earned. Deja Vu celebrating his debut win on TLW Action. Now, later on the night, again, we have the Lil Nasty's announcement about what match he's going to choose against AK, who just won, just earlier tonight, won his match against Ruckus. And wait, I guess our general manager has something to say.
I can see through you, see your true colors.
Wait a second.
Inside your ugly.
That's not our general manager. Yet that is his music.
I can see through you.
Who the hell is this? Yo, who the hell is this?
Scratcher.
What the hell is going on here? Wait a second. Who the hell is it? You gotta be kidding. No, it's not. That is not him. Okay. I'm getting word. I know who it is. And nobody told me this was scheduled. And I don't even think this was scheduled. This guy was coming. And now, I'm not even for sure if who they tell me who it is, if it is actually who it is. I'm just gonna wait and see what's going on, because I don't believe who it is. I honestly don't believe this, who this person is. So either my source is right here, the guy sitting next to me, or he's off camera whenever he zooms in on me. This guy a couple feet down just told me who it is. Oh, wait a second, he's grabbing the mic. Let's see. The old me. I don't even know this guy.
I can see through you, see your true colors inside your ugly light ring. I can see through you, see to the real.
I am speechless and shocked. Wow. That's all I can say right now. I remember him getting hurt. I remember this whole situation. I did not realize that was forced. And oh wait, now I think the real gem is actually coming out.
See your true colors.
Yes. Wow. I'm still shocked. Okay, yeah, he was a jobber. Honestly, he kind of was a jobber. But yeah. This is one different moment I was not expecting. I seriously thought DJ Green was hurt and decided not to come back. I did not know that John Green forced him out of wrestling. Tainted, yes. Yes, that's what I heard that he calls himself now. Tainted, and this is crazy. Wait a second here. Pyro? What? And his group? Well, that looks like Big Jack James and Brian Mercer? Oh my, what the hell is going on here? Wait a second, Pyro's the same guy that took out DJ Green last time. Oh my gosh, we have to take a commercial break, but do not click away. This is one ugly situation. TLW.